Welcome back to the IBFP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Fanboys, be advised, this video contains the absolute truth, may cause hurt feelings, and a need to thumbs down the video. Oscar Valdez and Shakur Stevenson both want the smoke. It's a 50-50 fight. Look, let's just break it down honestly and objectively as possible. And we saw after Oscar Valdez came out of a dominant knockout win over Miguel Berchelt, you know, Shakur Stevenson took to social media to congratulate him and to also call him out. He states, congrats champ to Oscar Valdez. I respect what you did tonight. It surprised me. There's only one fight to make now, and that's implying with him. Oscar Valdez has responded to him via the post-fight interview and stated, I heard Shakur Stevenson wants to fight. Let's do it. And you know, you've even seen Oscar Valdez come out and state a little bit more on this, and he stated, I'm not scared of fighting no other fighter. I'm ready for whoever, all the champion, whoever wishes to unify and up and coming fighters. He also stated, Shakur Stevenson has been calling me out, and I want to prove that we're not ducking nobody. So this is truly free smoke between both of these guys. Both of these guys are talented, and I truly see this as a 50-50 fight. But not only that, you also see that Shakur Stevenson is the WBO mandatory for the winner of the Jamel Herring and Carl Frampton fight. So, you know, he has two options. He can either wait and face, Oscar Valdez after he goes after the winner of that fight and try to unify belts. And that is likely the path he will take. But this is truly a 50-50 fight. When you look at Oscar Valdez and Shakur Stevenson, both of these guys have skills, both of these guys have talents, both of these guys are good fighters, quality fighters, top level fighters, and borderline elite fighters. And literally this fight could go either way. And look, let's just break it down. You start with a guy like Oscar Valdez, you see he's done something really no one else in the division has done, and that's come out dominating an elite fighter who's been a long reigning champion by knockout. And you see, that's what he did to Miguel Berchelt. No one else has done that. He's made a statement in the division that this is his division, and he's currently the king of it. I mean, look at it like this. Oscar Valdez also has two paths to victory over a guy like Shakur Stevenson. He can win via a brutal knockout if he catches him clean, or he can win on the cards if he constantly and consistently keeps hurting Shakur Stevenson. I mean, with knockdowns, make him hesitant and tentative to punch, keep him on the back foot, make the guy want to cover up and not throw shots, because he's never felt this type of power before. And we know Oscar Valdez's power is elite for the division. His defense is much improved. His footwork looks much improved. His decision making, looks great. And, you know, and his shot selection looks much improved as well. His timing is borderline elite. Hitting a guy at the right time on the right spot, the guy looks much better with Eddie Reynoso in his corner, constantly improving and developing. And not only that, you know, you see Eddie Reynoso is one of the reasons why this fight has to be a 50-50 fight, because Eddie Reynoso is obviously the best trainer in the world right now. I mean, you got this guy, Eddie Reynoso, coming off a victory with Ryan Garcia, knocking out Luke Campbell when everyone said Ryan wasn't ready for it. You see him coming in and getting a victory over Miguel Berchelt with Oscar Valdez when, you know, Berchelt was clearly the favorite in that fight, and he's elevated Canelo Alvarez to the pound for pound number one fighter in the world. So you have to take your hat off to Eddie Reynoso. The guy is the best trainer in the world, and having him in your corner with the game plan and preparation definitely has to turn the fight in your favor at some point. But not only that, you see Shakur Stevenson has his own benefits in this fight. On the other hand, you look at a guy like Shakur Stevenson, he's not been tested at the elite level like Oscar Valdez. We don't know how he'll handle pressure, but he has been a world champion before. He is an undefeated fighter, and he's looked dominant literally in every single fight he's ever had. Shakur Stevenson is truly a special talent, and one that you don't see come along too often. His defense, speed, timing are impeccable. His ring IQ looks to be elite. His overall skill set looks to be lacking nothing. He has it all except power. His lack of power makes the Valdez fight a lot more dangerous for him, considering there's only one guy throwing fire in this fight, and that's Oscar Valdez. But you see a guy like Shakur Stevenson looks to even things up, because you see he's the type of guy who's been sparring and training with guys like Terrence Bud Crawford. That's the type of work that can improve you. You got to think about it like this. Just like with Oscar Valdez training and sparring with guys like Canelo Alvarez, we see the type of benefits getting sparring and work from an elite fighter can help hone in your skills, help, you know, improve you as a fighter and help take you to the next level. And a guy with a lot of natural abilities in like Shakur Stevenson, fighting and sparring and training with a guy like Terrence Bud Crawford can only make you better. But that's not the only guy he's stepping in training with. That's not the only guy he's learning from. And it's also Andre SOG Ward as well, who's a Hall of Fame fighter. So you got to see that this kid is taking all the right steps. He's learning a lot and it's showing in all of his performances. You've also seen him in the ring sparring with guys like Vasily Lomachenko. He's even stated, you know, hey, I beg to come spar with Lomachenko. I asked a lot of top ranked people if I could come to Oxnard and spar with him. He also went on to state, I'm going to leave camp a new man. I feel like I learned a lot this camp. I learned a lot of inside work with Lomachenko. It's amazing to be in the ring with someone as great as him. So you see that that type of work can only benefit you, can only help you. And he's looked even more dominant fight by fight by fight. Shakur Stevenson looks primed for the big time in this type of work. Helps him. But the reason why this is truly a 50-50 fight is because you see Oscar Valdez has the power. He has the power to end the fight at any given moment in a brutal, vicious fashion. But Shakur Stevenson also has something up his sleeve, and that's his height and reach advantage. You got to understand, a height and reach advantage, you know, with a guy who's as skilled as Shakur Stevenson is going to be a major factor in this fight, you know, because he knows how to manage the distance. He knows how to control a fight from range. He knows how to pick his shots, and he knows how to counter with that height and reach advantage. That's going to be crucial in this fight. I mean, you got to look at it like this. It's making up for the power that he lacks. And you know, you see that, is he going to let a guy like Oscar Valdez work his way inside? Because if he does, he could be toast. He could be out. But at the same time, Oscar Valdez may not be able to land a shot if he's kept at range, if he's kept at distance. It's going to be an intriguing matchup. It's truly a 50-50 fight. And based on styles, this fight can literally go either way. But once again, honest and unbiased as always, it's the IBFP.